I just want to quickly add on to what Jim showed you and help you think about this limit graphically. So here's the same function in the same graph we just looked at a few slides ago. Once again, the function is x squared minus 1 over x minus 1. And just like Jim showed you, the function doesn't exist at x equals 1, right? Because if we plug in x equals 1 to this function, we get 0 over 0. So the function doesn't exist there. And you can see on the graph that there's a hole in the function at x equals 1. But even though the function doesn't exist at x equals 1, we can still find the limit as x approaches 1. Jim showed you how to estimate that limit using a table, but let me just very briefly show you how to think about it graphically as well. Okay, so remember when we're trying to find the limit from the graph, we want to think about sort of traveling along the line or traveling along the curve or whatever you may have towards the x value in question. So here, I'm thinking about the limit as x goes to 1. So if you can kind of picture that, here's x equals 1, and I'm going towards x equals 1 along the line. I want to think about it from both directions. Okay, what y value am I approaching? Okay, so I'm approaching a y value of 2, right? As I get closer and closer to the x value of 1, I approach the y value of 2. So that's why the limit as x goes to 1 of this function is 2. So it's completely okay that the function doesn't exist there, because I'm just thinking about the limit.